How to remember hypertonic and hypotonic is driving me crazy. There must be a way to learn this stuff once and for all.
Let me guess, as soon as someone says hypertonic or hypotonic, all that you remember is some kind of tonic, but not the one that has gin and ice in it?
That is absolutely right. Hyper of hypo, it all sounds the same to me.
Well, in that case, let me help out a bit. The tonic part is the same in both words.
Yes, tonic stands for tonicity.
Exactly. And the tonicity is a measure of how much matter is present in a substance aside from water, but compared to another substance. The same measure determines how these substances will mix and combine when they come in contact.
That is why it is often used to describe the response cells have when they are immersed in a solution or substance of external nature.
Yes. In that case, tonicity determines the extent of pressure that the same substance produced on the cell membrane. All the components of the substance that can enter through the membrane do not exert pressure. Like a dog that slips through a pet door, while a large man continues to push onto it.
Thanks for that weird image, but I knew most of that and I still don't know how to remember hypertonic and hypotonic, in spite of your small dog-large man comparison.
Hold on, we're getting there. Now that we know you know what tonicity stands for, we will discuss the notions of hyper and hypo.
Good, because I'm getting pretty hyper about this whole thing.
That is exactly what will help you remember. Hypertonic is a reference to a greater concentration. In a biological context, when a cell is placed in a hypertonic solution, the water from the cell will flow into the solution. Hyper means more, so remember that hypertonic stands for more concentration outside of the cell.
Hyper for more. That makes sense.
At the same time, hypo is the opposite. Hypotonic solution is the one where the concentration is lower, so that the water goes into the cell. Remember this for the animal hypo, which swims in the waters, and think of it swimming out of the low concentration towards a substance of a cell which has a higher concentration.
This finally makes more sense. The hyper is the larger one, so the water flows into it while the hypo is lower. And here that cute little water hypo of yours needs to swim out of it.
Correct. You got it.